Why, hello YouTube. Hello. I have this computer here. It's an Acer Aspire V5. And I'm gonna try to fix this thing. So a neighbor gave it to me, and what happens is when you turn it on and it boots up here, and what happens is that the hard drive's in there, everything's good. It's just when it boots, something happened to the hard drive. And so when it tries to boot here and get into Windows, it gives this weird little error here. I don't know if it's gonna, yeah. So boot device missing or boot failed, insert recover media, blah, 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 blah. So I hit OK, I hit Enter here. And it's telling me to change the boot option to something that actually has Windows on it. Well, the hard drive, I'm 100% positive, is dead. So I have to switch out the hard drive, and then once I do that, I can use the media creation tool and such that Windows and Microsoft has made, so we can do that. One of the reasons also I knew that, or I'm pretty sure that the hard drive is bad, is the hard drive, it's an older hard drive, so it has a disk in there spinning, and I put my ear up to the computer, and I heard a little whir, whir, whir. You know, like it was trying to spin, it was trying to boot, but it couldn't. So anyways, so what I'm going to do and what this video is going to be about is we're going to open up this computer. We're going to take out the hard drive. I got another one from Amazon. We're going to throw that one in there, and I'll go through step by step how I do all this. So hopefully it'll be very similar if you have your own computer. Things will be a little bit different here and there, but that's the point of this video, is hopefully to help you switch out the hard drive if you need to, and how to reinstall Windows. This had Windows 8 on it. I think Windows 8 is an abomination, so we'll put 10 on it after we get Windows 8.1 installed on it. So, anyways, so let's take apart the computer and get the hard drive out of it. All right, first thing you're going to want to do is make sure there's no power running to the computer. Now, yes, the battery's going to be on there, and probably in a perfect world, if you could somehow take the battery out, you'd want to. But this is one of these really dang small computers, so can't really do it that way. I'm just gonna have to be careful and not static discharge anything. So I already did this, but in each one of these little holes here, there's a screwdriver. I just have this little, I don't know, pen screwdriver thing. So I just went through all these different holes, and I pulled out the screwdriver for all of those, or I pulled out the screws for all of those. Now, one of the tricky ones was right here. This actually had a little rubber stamp over it. So I was sitting here trying to pull this thing off, and I couldn't because there was still a screw right there. So as you're doing it, just make sure there's no rubber things or anything that would be hiding a screw. But once I get all the screws off, I'm going to take the flathead part of this, and I'm just going to stick it in here, and I'm just going to kind of pry it open and go around until it's off. Each computer is going to be different on how you have to do this, but it's almost always there's a bunch of screws. Take the screws out, and then you just need some sort of small flathead like this to kind of pry around the edges, kind of push up and down, go left and right like that until you snap it all off, and then you should be able to pull it off. So that's what I'm going to do here. That's what I'm going to do next. Another thing worth mentioning is this has an SD card slot right here. And there was one of those fake plastic ones in there. So I'd pull that out because that was actually sticking out and it was making it so I couldn't pull this off. And then another thing worth mentioning is over here is the, I don't know, the mic input or the stereo input. See how that sticks out a little bit? So when I was pulling that off, I kind of had to pull this plastic part out a little bit, like this way, to pull it out and over that. But just don't force it. If you force it, you could easily break the components on the motherboard, or you could break. There's just a lot of different things you could break that you don't want to. You could snap the shell, which is kind of hard to do, but just be careful. And don't, especially if it's not coming off, don't rip it off, because when I was trying to do that with that screw, I could have totally busted something. Just make sure all the screws are out first. Once you've pried it open, it should easily just lift off. So I'm gonna do that now. Okay, so I got it off. So we're just gonna put that over here. Now, just as a quick rundown, here's the hard drive right here. This is going to be, that's that little, I think it's a mic plug-in right there. It's a USB port there. That's where the power goes. Now, this has a SATA connection, so I got to somehow pull this off. And then usually the hard drives are going to have screw holes here. There's one here. But this one didn't have them in there. Somebody already took them out for whatever reason. And what's really fun is it has this ribbon cable right over it, which we don't want. We got to remove the ribbon so we can pull out the hard drive. And then also, if you care, this is your RAM right here. This only has one RAM slot. So if you ever wanted to upgrade the RAM, you usually want, at the time of this recording, 8 gigs of RAM is good, is where you want to be. 4 is okay, but that can slow things down. And then this is the processor, and this is a little fan that keeps the processor cold. And then right here is your Wi-Fi, the Wi-Fi chip that gives you internet. So anyways, this has 4 gigs of RAM, so if I wanted to upgrade that, I'd have to get a stick that had 8. I couldn't buy another stick and put it in there because there's only one slot. But anyways, this is the speaker here, and then this was the SD card slot. So anyways, just giving a quick overview there. So what I need to do is I got to get this cable off, and to do that, you can see right here that has this little clip. I just need to push that clip up. So I can do that with my screwdriver. Almost all these cables have something like that, where there's a little part that goes up or down and it chomps down on the cable. So I lifted that up, and then usually once you do that, the cables come out pretty easily. So I just pull that off, so I'm good. Next thing I want to do is just check the hard drive to see if there's any screws on there. If there was one here, I'd obviously want to take that off. If there was one here, I'd want to take that off. There was one here too. I already took all these out just because I wanted to show you. So if there's any screws, you're just going to take them out. The main thing you want to know and realize is that the hard drive can easily be removed. That's what you want. So I'm just going to take that. Can't really do this with one hand. Be really careful that you don't pull too hard. Also, another thing to check is this right here is where the hard drive plugs into the motherboard. So that could be loose too. Could be that the hard drive is fine. This is just loose, and that's why it can't read a hard drive. But I already checked that, and it still gave me the hard drive error. And like I said, I heard the hard drive making that weird noise. So anyways, what I'm going to do is unplug this. You just pull it out that way, and it unplugs. It should unplug real easy, and then the hard drive will be out. So I'll do that right now. Alrighty, here it is. Got it out. So once it's out, what I did is I just kind of pulled this black thing up a little bit to get the information off of the drive. So it's a Toshiba drive, the disk drive MQ01ABF050. That's the actual kind of serial number, I guess, of the drive. That's what I put in with Amazon and eBay to kind of find a replacement drive. Got one off Amazon, 20 bucks, 2-day shipping, love Prime, it's good stuff. So what I need to do now is I got to look at the side, and you see, I don't know if you can't see, yeah, there's screws on the side. This hard drive is sitting in a case, so I'm going to have to take these screws out on the side, and then I can pull the hard drive out, and then I can put the new one in this case. And here's my new one, haven't even unboxed it yet. But really quick, if you're doing this on your computer, I would highly recommend you stay away from these old drives. Get a solid state drive, an SSD drive. They're so much faster. Windows boots really quick. Windows doesn't really slow down on them either. With these older drives, Windows slows down after a year or two. With these new ones, if you get a solid state drive, they're just faster. They don't have the turning components in here. This actually has a disc right here that spins. That's actually what failed on this drive. But get a solid state. They're made of flash memory like thumb drives. They are so much faster. They don't slow down over time, and they just make your computer really quick. And this one doesn't have a lot of RAM. The processor's horrible. It's a dual core 1.0 gigahertz. I mean, it's really slow. So a solid state drive for a computer like this would be perfect. You can get that off Amazon, eBay, Newegg, Tiger Direct. You go to all those sites, you'll find a good deal. So I'm gonna get that out of the little thing. of the little case here. I'm going to take the screws off on the sides, pull that out, and then I'm going to put the new one in there, and we'll go from there. All right, so got it out of the case. So those are the screws right here that I pulled off from the sides. And you can see that the drive has these little places where you put the screws. Can't really see it with the light, sorry. But anyways, so once the screws are out, I just lifted it out. And here's the new drive. So we'll just do, we're just going to put that in the way it was before. So put the new drive in there. And I will then take these screws. I'll probably put one on the corner here and then one on the corner here just to keep it in. You don't want to put, since I don't have all four, you don't want to put one on both sides. Won't hold it in as good. So I'll put one here and put one there. And once I do that and get that screwed in, then I can just put that back in. So we'll do that and we'll be back. Alright, so I got the new drive in the little container thing here. So this is the new drive. All I did is I just put the screw there and then the other screw right there. So the next part is I'm just going to put it in the way it was. Thing here is there's a little hole there and there's a plastic pin. You want to make sure that that's in there so it doesn't move. And then I do have two of these little screws that are meant to keep the hard drive in place. So I'm going to put one there, kind of do the same diagonal thing here. I'll put one there and then I'll put one there. I don't have one for that, but that's okay. The two should be fine. And then all I'm going to do is just take that and plug it in. And once I get the screws in and get that plugged in, we will go from there. Okay, so the way this worked is I had to plug this in first because this was in the way. So I had to angle it up, plug that in, put it down, screwed that in there, screwed that in there. Now the next thing I got to do is put this cable back in there. So first thing I got to do is lift that up, lift up the clip. I need two hands to do this, but I'm basically going to take this and I'm going to kind of push it in. Ah, well, you know what? I may be able to do this one-handed. Maybe not. Yeah, there we go. You can see it has a little dark line on it, and that tells you that's basically where this needs to go. So if you close it and you can't see the black line anymore, you're good. And it's in where it needs to be. And the same thing there on this other side. You can kind of see the black line, so I may need to push that in a little bit. But if the black line's gone when you put that clip down, you got it and you got it good. So I'm good there. I'm probably going to push that in a little bit more. But once I've done that, then I'm going to put that back on. And these are all the screws that I have, and I'm just going to screw them all back on. So I'll take a look at that cable, probably push it in a little bit more, and then I'll put that on, and we'll go from there. Okay, so the little black clip, same thing. I lifted it up, and I just pushed the cable in a little bit more and put it back down. So now we're good. Now it's just a matter of taking that, sticking it back on, and you just kind of push until you hear it kind of snap into place. You want to make sure that that's lined up. If there's anything kind of sticking out, that's the power button right there. Now the fun thing about these screws is you can see some of them are bigger than the others. So really they usually design it good enough to where if you're sitting there and you're trying to screw it in, you're turning and turning, it doesn't go in. It's probably the wrong type of screw. If it fits, yeah, you're good to go. And then here's the little rubber thing I was talking about that covered that last screw that kind of messed me up a little bit. And then here's that plastic thing that goes into the SD drive. So anyways, I'm going to put that back in the SD drive. I'm going to put all the screws back in and then I'm going to put the rubber thing on, and then we'll be able to get in there and hopefully see if it recognizes the hard drive. So we'll screw it in and screw in all the screws, and we'll go from there. All right, before I went and screwed all those in, I just thought it'd be a good idea to test it just to make sure, because if things are wrong, then I just have to unscrew everything and hop back in there anyways. So anyways, just turned it on. We'll see what happens. All right, so it's still giving me that problem, which is fun. So maybe just the computer's host. So I'm going to go into the BIOS then. So I'm going to press and hold the power button. And I'm going to hit the power button again. Now, usually to get into the BIOS, it's like F2. In this case, it is F2. That'll get you in there. And I know this isn't the greatest thing in the world, but it does see the hard drive. You can see that. So come on, HDD model name Toshiba, it has that there as a serial number, so we may just have to tell it to recognize it here. So there is, we're good there. All right, so now when we go to the boot, it does recognize the hard drive here, which is good. And I didn't record this, but it didn't have that before. So the fact that it recognizes it, to be honest, we're probably okay. And it doesn't have anything to boot off of because it's a hard drive that's been totally wiped. So what we need to do now is I'm going to finish screwing all this stuff in, put in the rubber thing and all that. But also what we need to do now is we need to create a bootable USB drive that has Windows 8.1 on it. And then we got to tell this computer to boot from there and install Windows on this hard drive that we just put in. So that's what we'll do next. I'm going to hop into kind of a screen share environment and show you how to create the bootable drive. But anyways, we'll do that soon. See ya. All right, just kidding on the screen share. We're going to do that here in a minute. You're going to need, I mean, you can do this on a DVD or you can do it on a CD, but that requires that you burn it on the disk. Discs, sometimes the burning doesn't work very well. USBs are just, you know, it's just like the hard drive. Like this failed because there was spinning parts in it. This is flash memory. Flash memory is a lot better. It just doesn't die as quick. And so I think booting off a USB is a lot better, in my opinion. It's just, you don't have to worry about burning disks and maybe the burning going wrong. I've been reinstalling Windows from USBs now for a while, and I just think it works a lot better. So you want one of these. You want at least, I don't know, 10 gigs or so. You can get them at Walmart for really cheap now. This one I think is a 16 gig or something. I got it for like $6 or something. It was really cheap. So I put the rubber thing back on, and then I put the thing back in the SD card. So what you'll do is you need to get a USB drive, plug it into your computer. I'm going to do this on my laptop, this thing over there. I'm going to do that on my laptop, and we'll hop into the screen share right now, and I'll show you what to do once you plug this into your laptop.
Alrighty, welcome to the screen share portion. So we got the hard drive into the computer. We know that it recognized it because we went into the BIOS and we saw that. So now what we need to do is install Windows onto that new hard drive. So Microsoft actually created a new way of doing this, which is cool. It's called a media creation tool. They make it so you can take that thumb drive or that flash drive that you have, plug it into your computer, and then using this tool, it'll create and put Windows onto that USB drive so you can then boot off of it. So that's what we're going to do. But before, I just want to talk to you a couple other tools that are really, really cool. There's this Magic Jelly Bean tool. It's a key finder. Microsoft has really done something annoying. Back in the day, you could look at the bottom of the computer and get the product key for Windows off of that sticker that was on the bottom. So you just type it in, boom, Windows would be registered, life would be great. But they became annoying, and they don't do that anymore. So what they do now is they, like, from what I understand, they hard code the product key into the BIOS, and they make it ridiculously hard to get unless you use this amazing tool here. The magical jellybean.com/keyfinder. If you come down here and you just grab this free version and you run it and install it, when you run it, the first window that comes up, it'll give you the key to Windows, the key to your Windows, your version of Windows, which is amazing. So I've used this to get the keys off of computers when I'm reinstalling Windows and re-imaging everything. And so it's a really awesome tool. I just wanted to tell you about that. Now, if for some reason you can't use the media creation tool, if you're doing something with Windows 7, there's a thing called Rufus. And what Rufus does is it looks like this, and it what you can do is download the ISO or the CD image. If you don't know what that is, don't worry about it because we're not really going to need it for this video. But if you can get the ISO image or the CD image of Windows 7, you can then take that ISO, and what Rufus will do is it'll put it on a USB drive and make it a bootable USB drive. It's just doing what the media creation tool is going to do. So I've been using that for Windows 7 stuff. Microsoft, again, used to give out their ISOs so you could reinstall Windows and put in your product key and everything would be great, but they've kind of stopped doing that from what I understand now, and so that's kind of annoying. If you know of a good spot where the ISOs are, let me know. Okay, so what we're going to do is do a search for media creation tool, Windows 8, and I'm just going to hop to this first one here. And just scroll down here where it says create media. So I'm going to click on that, and I'm going to download this to my desktop. So click desktop, hit save. This tool, I'm in Chrome, so it shows up in the lower left-hand corner. If you're in Firefox, it's going to be in the upper right. So I'm going to run this tool. And again, you need to make sure that your USB drive is plugged in. Hit yes. Now what this does is you need to pick your language. So we're United States here. The edition. I checked on this computer beforehand. I know it's an Acer N, I think 5P something. Anyways, I looked up the model number on the website to see what version of Windows it came with. And it came with 8.1. So I was good. So I'm just going to install 8.1. You probably are never really going to mess with these other ones. So you're going to pick 8.1. Architectures 32 or 64. Really, to figure that out, I'm on Windows 10 here. I can just come over to my PC, right click, and go to properties, and it'll tell me right here it's a 64-bit operating system. Most computers nowadays are 64-bit. So if you don't know, on Windows 8, you can click on the start button and then just type in my computer, and then this PC will come up, right click it, go to properties, and then it'll be the same screen that you just saw on my screen. See if it's 64-bit or not. Chances are, if you bought the computer in the last 2 or 3 years, and it's 2015 right now, it's 64-bit. So I'm gonna pick that and hit next. Now, you can just grab the ISO file if you want. Sorry. Get the ISO file if you want, and then use something like Rufus, like I showed, to be able to create a bootable drive. But we already have the flash drive, so I'm just going to pick USB flash drive, hit next. There's the flash drive that I plugged in. I hit next, and I'm not going to do it because I've already done it. But you hit next, it downloads Windows, and then it just does everything you need, and then it'll say, hey, it's done. If this doesn't work, I actually tried this a couple days ago. It didn't work, so I had to end up using Rufus. But anyway, so just hit next. It'll download everything it needs, and then when it says it's done, you're good. And you have your bootable USB drive, which you will need, and which we will now go to, and I'll show you how to get Windows to install off of the flash drive once you've used this media creation tool. Cool. So we'll, yeah, we're gonna go there now. So see you.
Okay, now that I got use the media creation tool to put that on the flash drive here, I'm plugging in the flash drive and I'm just going to turn on the computer. Now, chances are it's not going to boot straight off the USB. You can hit some buttons if you want. If it does, great. But if usually it doesn't. So it gives me that same error. I'm going to hit enter. Now, I know this is lame. I hate recording BIOS from an actual camera, but you know, it is what it is. So it's still giving me the same issues. So I'm going to press and hold the power button here to turn it off. I need to get into the BIOS. So I'm going to turn it on my computer. It's F2. I'm just going to kind of mash F2 until I get into the BIOS. There we go. On your computer, it might be F2, it might be F8, it might be F12. It's different on different computers. So what I need to do is I need to come over here to boot and take a look at what the boot mode is. And what this is, it tells me, so the first one it's going to try to boot off of right here is the hard drive, and then it's going to look for a USB, then it's going to look for network and stuff. I don't want the first thing to be the hard drive because I want it to boot off the flash drive, not the hard drive. But also this boot mode, UEFI, I don't even know what that is, to be honest, but I know that if I have that set to UEFI, my flash drive won't work. So I'm going to use the arrow keys and I'm going to select that. I'm going to hit enter and I want it to be legacy. And then I'm going to hit enter. It says the available boot devices will not change until a reboot. That's fine. Hit OK. So what legacy does is it allows me to boot off of that flash drive. For whatever reason, the UEFI won't work. I don't know enough to know why. All I know is I need to change that to legacy and then that will work. So now what I want to do is do what it says here, F10, save and exit. So I'm going to hit F10. It says, do you want to save? I'm going to hit yes. So that reboots. I'm going to hit F2 again. Okay. Now I'm going to come back over to boot. Okay, and now I can there's some other, so there it is, the SanDisk Cruiser Glide. So what I could do, this says use F6 to move it up the list or F5 to move it down the list. So I can hit F6 to move that up, up, up. So now what that does is it says it's going to boot off of my, this is a SanDisk Cruiser, that's what it's called. So it's going to boot off my SanDisk before it's going to boot off my Toshiba hard drive. I can do it that way. Another thing that was kind of cool is right here it has an F12 boot menu, which means when I turn it off and then I turn it back on, I can hit F12. And then that's just, it'll just ask me, you know, what do you want to boot off of? So I'm going to do both. So I'm going to go to the boot. So I make it so the SanDisk, it'll try to boot off the SanDisk first before the hard drive. Then I'm going to come over here to main and I'm going to turn on this F12 boot menu. So I hit enter, I press the down arrow key, and then I press enter to enable that. So I'm just using the arrow keys, by the way, to navigate through and enter to select. So now that I made those two changes, I'm going to hit F10. So do you want to save configuration changes and exit now? Yes, I do. Hit enter. So now hopefully we'll see some magic here. So now it gives me these extra options. I can't really see them, but it said F12. It said press F2 to go to BIOS and F12 to do the boot menu, is what it said down there. And again, that's going to be different depending on your computer. But you can see instead of it booting into Windows 8, it's doing something a little bit different. Because I told it to boot off the flash drive, it's booting off the flash drive, or at least I hope it is. If not, then I can go back to the boot menu. Well, it has to be doing something, yeah. It's got to work because there was nothing on that hard drive before. Okay, so the fact that even a Windows logo came up is good. So I told it to boot off the flash drive, which it is doing now, and that's why I get this. So language to install, yeah, I'm English all around. So this is a touch screen too, so I should be able to just hit next. Or you should be able to use the mouse thing and get it that way as well. So I'm going to go to install now. Now again, I'd said this computer has a really, really slow processor. So some of this may take a while. So I'm going to pause it here and then I'll resume it once it gets to where it needs to be. Okay, so I get to the accept and sign your life away screen to Microsoft. So I'm going to accept that, hit next. Okay, now what I always do, especially if you're installing Windows over some a hard drive that already has Windows on it, is I always do custom. Because what that'll do is it'll show you all the stuff that's on the drive. Well, there's nothing because it's already been wiped. But if you already had Windows installed, you would want to select this and just go to delete. Delete all the partitions, get rid of everything if you want. If you don't know what you're doing, that's what I recommend. If you want different partitions, you want to put like Mac on there or Windows and OS on there, you can. But here I'm just putting Windows on. So this is where I want Windows to be. And if there's two hard drives in the computer, you'll see two different hard drives as well. So like in my case, on that computer, I have a solid state drive on there and a normal hard drive. The normal hard drive just stores everything. In the solid state drive, I put Windows on there. So, but anyways, that's more than you need to know. So you just select the hard drive and you're going to hit next. Okay, and then it's going to start copying the files, and I'm just going to pause from here because this is going to take a while because this computer's slow. But now what it's doing is it's installing Windows. So anyways, I will continue once this finishes. All right, so it went through all its stuff, it rebooted, and now it's giving me this. Love it how you can read that. But it says getting devices ready. It's at 100% now. So now it just has to load everything. And what's going to be interesting to see is if this pre-registers. Usually when you use the media creation tool, that's kind of the one cool thing about the product key being on the hardware or on the BIOS, is you won't have to type it in. It'll just automatically realize that it's registered and it'll automatically activate it, which is kind of nice. But the thing is, I don't know if the product key, if it's on this, then we're in trouble. Not sure what we're going to do there, but we'll see. But if it pulls it from the BIOS, we should be okay. But anyway, so we'll see that. I'll pause the video here and I will resume it once something else pops up. Another thing that's worth mentioning is I've kept the USB plugged in, but once you've booted from it and you got to that screen where it was installing everything and then it rebooted and everything, don't ever boot from the USB again. When it reboots and then if it says press any key to boot from the USB, don't do it. Just leave it alone. To be honest, you can probably unplug the USB. I usually don't, but once it's doing all this stuff that it's doing right now, you're never going to boot from the USB again because it already installed everything that it needed to on the hard drive. So now it's accessing everything from the hard drive. So you don't ever have to boot from the USB again. So just be aware of that. Okay, so now it's asking me to personalize things. I'm just going to call it PC because I'm boring. You can pick whatever color you want. So getting online, you'll want to do that. You want to make sure that you want to get your hard drive or your network there. I'm picking my network. You definitely want to make sure it's connected to the internet because later on we're going to upgrade this to Windows 10 because Windows 8 is a joke. So okay, so now it's asking for my password for my network. I put it in, hit next. It will connect. The express settings, I would definitely customize this. This basically is saying that it sends all kinds of information to Microsoft that you may not be okay with. So anyways, do you want to find stuff on the network? Yeah, that's fine. Yeah, I want to automatically install updates. That's fine. I'm good there. Use smart screen? No. Well, yeah, why not? Yeah, I'm okay with that stuff. I'm okay with that. Yeah, but it'll usually say if it's sending information to Microsoft or not. But I would definitely go through this to make sure that you're okay with what it's saying. Because this is basically them spying on you in a way. Don't need to freak out about it, but just make sure that you're okay with sending the information that you do to Microsoft here. So like right here, so share information with other services. I don't want them knowing what I search on Bing. I don't want Internet Explorer sending stuff to them. That's okay. Advertising ID, I don't want them messing with that. I guess they can request my location, that's fine. And then Windows Defender, I'm okay with that as well. So again, just take a look at it, make sure that you grant the permissions that you want. So now it's going to set up my account. I'm going to pause it because this computer's slow. All right, this is another fun screen. Is it wants you to sign into your Microsoft account. If you don't want to, Microsoft is so unintuitive sometimes. So if you don't want to sign into an account, it basically makes it look like you have to. Like you just have to create a new account or sign in. But no, if you hit create a new account, it'll load. And again, this just doesn't make any sense. You hit create new account, and then once this loads, because again, this computer is so fast, then at the bottom, they have sign in without a Microsoft account. That's so messed up. But I'm pretty sure they made it that way, just to make it so you think you have to log in, because they want all your info. But I'm going to sign in without one. Username. I don't like having passwords on my computer, so I'm just going to put my username PC. I'm not going to put anything for password, and I'm just going to hit finish. If you want a password in there, go ahead. No, it has to be different than the name of the computer, so I'll go PC with an exclamation point, and then I'll hit finish. So I didn't put a password in there. I didn't want a password in there. Now it's going to set things up. I'm going to pause and come back because it's going to take a while. But once it loads and we're inside, oh, it's going to get updates as well. But once we're inside of Windows 8, I'll show you how to get Windows 10. Because I've been using Windows 10 for a few months now, and it's a lot better than 8. So, and you might as well get it for free. All right, so once it does that, I think it reboots one more time. It's going to start installing apps and taking care of this stuff. And going to take a while, just depend on how fast your computer is. With solid-state drives, this stuff goes a lot faster. But anyways, once this is done, we'll look at getting Windows 10 on this. Okay, this is interesting. So it's saying Microsoft recommends upgrading to Windows 10, and it's giving me the option. I can't really see it, but right there it says upgrade. If I was doing this just for me, I would hit upgrade and do it now. But because I want to show you how to do it, I'm going to hit do it later. So, I love how they do this, where they're just going to download in the background, even though you didn't tell them to, and then you can just install it whenever. So, well, I guess you can say don't decline the free upgrade. I'm not going to do that. So I'll just hit okay. All right. So now we're in the desktop area. And again, guys, sorry, I know, I realize that this would be way better as a screen share than on my dang phone. So, anyways, so what you got to do, I'm opening this, and sorry for the screaming kids in the background. Those of you that have kids, you must love it. I love having kids. It's the most incredible thing ever. So we're just going to do the exact same thing that we did before. Is we're just going, I gotta go get my kids, sorry. But what we're gonna do is download the media creation tool. And then we're just going to have it install Windows 10 instead of doing Windows 8. So we'll do that here once my children have settled down. Okay, children have settled, hopefully. So what I'm going to do is hit the Windows button here. And then it comes up and I'm just going to start typing in my computer in the keyboard, on the keyboard. Well, if I just do my, that works. So this PC is basically my computer. I'm going to right click that, go to properties. And I just want to make sure that this is activated. So if I look over here, Windows is activated. Great. So even though we replaced the hard drive, got rid of this piece of junk, it recognized that this is a registered version of Windows, which is awesome. So now what I want to do is upgrade to Windows 10. So one way you can do it, doesn't always work, is if you come down here in the lower right hand corner and click on that, you can do it this way sometimes. But this is what I usually get, is it's on the way, okay, notify me when it's ready. In other words, you gotta wait. Man, we're a society of give it to me now, so no, I don't wanna wait, that's lame. So I'm gonna close out of that, open up this ugly browser called Internet Explorer. Hate using it, but it is what it is. And I'm gonna go to Google. Okay. And then I'm just gonna type in Media Creation Tool Windows 10. So not Windows 8 this time, but Windows 10. I think the browser inherently hates Google and it doesn't want to go there. All right, there we go. So Media Creation Tool Windows 10. All right, and I'm going to go right here. This Windows 10-Microsoft. All right, and I'm just going to hit upgrade now. And now this will download the media creation tool for Windows 10 instead of Windows 8. And it should look and function very similar if it's going to go here. There we go. So I'm going to hit run. It should look and function very similarly to the Windows 8 one. And again, sorry for the recording the screen off the phone. It's kind of lame, but I just don't want to install a screen recorder on this computer. So I'm going to hit yes. Maybe. So there's a little Windows thing, just like it did with the Windows 8 one. I'm going to hit pause and come back when it... Oh, wait, no, we're good. It's going to get a few things ready. That's going to take a while, I'm pretty sure, on this computer. So I'm going to hit pause. I'll be back. All right, so after waiting for a few minutes, it started downloading Windows 10. So there's really not much more I'm going to have to do. It's going to download it. Once it's downloaded, I'll probably have to hit next a few more times. We'll see when it happens. But once it's downloaded, it'll start installing Windows 10. And because this is a fresh install of Windows 8, chances of there being issues is going to be pretty small. Because I don't have a bunch of drivers and weird stuff installed that may not be compatible with Windows 10. It's just basically almost like doing a clean install of Windows 10, just because we're going straight to 10. So anyways, once this is done downloading, we'll go from there. All right, next part is the license. Again, signing your life away. We're just going to accept that. Wait for a few seconds here. Okay, more updates. So once those are done, we will come back. Okay, so it's ready. I'm just gonna keep my personal files and apps, even though I haven't really done much. Just hit install. And there we go, some more waiting. So it's going to, like it says, it's gonna restart a couple times and I just kinda wait. I probably recommend doing this before you go to bed, something like that. But anyways, once it's done, we should be good, but I will keep recording. once it does something else. Well, here's another fun window, screen, whatever you want to call it. Upgrading Windows. Your PC will restart several times. Has to copy files, install a bunch of stuff. So again, we're waiting forever on this. So, fun stuff. Okay, so finally finished up here. So I'm going to go to next. And this is another one where you probably want to mess with the, and you want to customize the settings here. This is basically them saying, we're going to send all of our data to Microsoft. So I'm not sending them my typing data. I'm not sending them my speech and type or my inking stuff. No, I don't want that. I don't really do Skype. Okay with that. I'm okay with that. And I'm okay with all that. Don't really care about that. Browsing data does not need to be sent to Microsoft. I mean, this is crazy. They want to know all this. Sure. Well, that's okay. Cortana, I don't know. She's the little voice person that you can talk to. Might as well use her. Why not? I'm okay with those. Hit next. Well, hi everyone, here I am. All right, so we'll wait, we'll give it a few more seconds and then we'll go on from there once it comes back up. Oh, it just said hi to me. It's such a friendly computer. Welcome. Thank you. It might be done, which is kind of would be a happy day here. But yeah, I'm gonna stop just sitting here. I'll start recording when there's actually something to see. Okay, so there we are. It's up and running. Everything's good to go. The only thing I gotta do now is I'm gonna put virus protection on there. I recommend Avast. I've been using that for years. It's free, just use their free version. If they prompt you to pay for anything, don't worry about it. But I'm just gonna put Avast on there and everything should be good. And this computer is on its way. So if you have any questions, let me know. Hope that helps someone out there. We'll see you guys.